Greetings, beloveds. Welcome and peace be with you. I'm Reverend Mitzi. Something within you was calling you to watch. I'm so very glad that you answered that divine call. Welcome to Unity of Tempe Online. So how has your week been? How are you doing? This was actually a pretty challenging week for Ron and me because Ron's mum, Ron is my husband, as you know, Ron's mum, Joni, was admitted to hospital with COVID. Not the news that you want to get. Thankfully, now she has been released from hospital and she is recovering at a skilled nursing facility, and we pray that she continues to get better and just recover. We're so very grateful for all of your prayers. So many of you have been praying for us and for her, and especially on social media, the outpouring has been tremendous. Thank you so much, beloveds. So something came across my radar this week that perhaps like you had initially seen in late March. Doesn't March seem like a really long time ago now? It almost seems like a different lifetime. We had no idea where we were going to be when March began, right? But this is a beautiful version of a song that you all know, performed by the Camden Voices Choir. And it seems even more appropriate for us now than it did in March. And while this is Camden Voices' first ever virtual performance, well, actually they've done some since then, it is certainly not Camden Voices Choir first performance, because they are an accomplished choir hailing from my hometown of London. And when COVID struck, they refocused their energy to create something positive, something that would help inspire and something that would help calm and be inspirational. And I'm so glad that they did. And I contacted them this past week because I love this song and this version of it so much. And guess what? They gave me permission to share it with all of you in this message. Now, of course, it's on YouTube too, but I actually do have permission from them to share it in this message. Now, I invite you to grab a couple of tissues because this may move you to tears in a good way.
You with the sad eyes, don't be discouraged, or I realize it's hard to take courage in the world full of people. You can lose sight of it all. The darkness inside you can make you feel so small. I see your true colors shining through. I see your true colors, and that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let them show your true colors are beautiful, oh, like a rainbow. I see your true colors shining through. I see your true colors, and that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let them
true colors, are beautiful.
Oh, like a rainbow.
Ooh. I see your true colors shining through. I see your true colors, and that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let them show your true colors. True colors are beautiful. I see your true colors shining through. I see your true colors, and that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let them show
your true colors are beautiful, so beautiful like a rainbow.
Wasn't that beautiful? So stunning, so beautiful, so heart moving. So don't be afraid to let them show. Your true colors are beautiful. Ah, take a deep breath. If you're like me, that really touched your heart. I can't watch that without crying, tears just freely flowing. Incredible Cyndi Lauper song, soul-stirring performance by Camden Voices Choir. Thank you again for letting me share that. So let's explore the words of the song further. You with the sad eyes, don't be discouraged. Oh, I realize it's hard to take courage. In a world full of people, you can lose sight of it all. The darkness inside you can make you feel so small. Sometimes, don't we try so hard not to let any of what is going on get to us? We try so very, very hard to stay centered in spirit that we push down any so-called negative feelings. Stuff them down. Don't let them show. Don't let anyone know. But there's a problem with that, beloveds, because when we refuse to let out our true feelings, because subconsciously or consciously, we deem them spiritually unacceptable, spiritually inferior, we're actually hurting ourselves. We're engaging in a form of denial, and it is not healthy at all. It's vitally important to give ourselves permission to experience our feelings. And while we don't want to get stuck in them, if we don't acknowledge them and safely release them, they just continue to fester. Uncle Fester, remember? Uncle Fester from the Addams Family. They just continue festering until we either let them out or we make ourselves sick. We are not small or less than in any way for acknowledging how we feel. We're not small for feeling confused or scared or worried or any range of emotions right now. We're not small for crying or screaming or even using colorful language to express our exasperation and bewilderment with what we're living through, especially when we watch the news and we see how it is being handled. The truth is, beloveds, that even when we don't feel centered in God, that divine Christ presence is within us. Even when we feel our most uncentered, God is there. Even when we feel that we're free falling, we will always be caught by the net of God's love that will never, never, ever, ever let us go. That net of love extends to other trusted people in our lives too, allowing us to simply be wherever we are with our feelings. As the lyrics go, "Can't remember when I last saw you laughing. This world makes you crazy and you've taken all you can bear. Just call me up, 'cause I will always be there." Thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God, thank you God, for the trusted ones with whom we can simply be ourselves. What a blessing it is too when we can be the same for others, a safe harbor where friends can be vulnerable and authentic with their deepest feelings. That's when our true colors are the most beautiful. For me, our true colors represent, particularly in these difficult times, the ability to integrate our abundance of feelings into a vision for humanity. Into one hand, we pour our feelings of confusion, grief, dismay, anger, bewilderment, sadness, grief, whatever feelings we have, uncertainty, you name it, we pour it in. And into the other hand, we place our desired vision, our intention for the world we want to create and live in. And then we merge them together. Now let's look at this in more detail. Into our left hand, we place our complex mix of emotions, the human feelings that we came to this planet to experience. We came to experience the whole range of emotions. And when we're ready to release the ones that are painful and ultimately not beneficial, we let them run through our fingers like sand. We feel them. Yes, we do. We feel them as we release them, but we allow them to completely go. But we hold on to emotions that allow us to reveal more of our highest self, the feelings that support us in evolving from the world of me into the world of we, feelings of courage, strength, altruism, love, comfort, support for all. Now I know, beloveds, that it seems that we are currently stuck in the world of me. It seems like if there's a vinyl going around, that the needle just got stuck on me, 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 me. We see that being played out across the country many times right now. And you've heard me talk before about how we are constantly and simultaneously evolving and devolving. And this cycle, well, it's ramped up right now. And you may feel like, well, we're in a state of devolution. Where is the revolution of evolution? Where is it? We just feel like we're devolving. Where's the up cycle? Why can't I see it right now? Well, that's because when something new wants to be birthed, when we're being called into a higher expression of consciousness for humanity, there's often tremendous pushback. Push back. Nope. Push it back. Push it back. Push, pull, forward, back. Push back. It's a tug of war that can go on for a very long time. Stasis doesn't like change. And this is true for us individually. Think about when you want to make a change in your life. Sometimes it's really challenging. We want to move forward and do something, but everything comes up inside of us and says, yeah, not so fast, buddy. And that's also true for us collectively. Think about movements and things that have happened that have taken a time, sometimes many, many, many years and much hard work to come to fruition. Think about emancipation, the end of slavery. How long, how many years did that take? How much blood, sweat, and tears and lives were fought to make that a reality? Think about women's suffrage. Women got the vote, but they didn't get it easily. It didn't just happen overnight. It was a lot of really, really dedicated women and men holding that intention and taking action to make it a reality. Think about the civil rights movement and blessings and Godspeed John Lewis, an icon of a leader of the civil rights movement. And what about seatbelt laws? Something that I've heard that is not really in the same realm of what we've been talking about, but it also has saved countless lives. Yet I'm told that when that first emerged, there was pushback. No, don't want to wear a seatbelt. And what about not being able to smoke on a plane? Apparently, there was tremendous pushback about that, something we take for granted now. If you get on a plane, which most of us aren't doing right now, you're not smoking on a plane. Actually, I don't know anyone really who does smoke these days, but no one's smoking on a plane. All thanks to countless hours of work and intention and vision and action by people. And the birthing of a higher expression of humanity, like childbirth itself, is painful. Currently, it's excruciatingly painful. So much sickness and death, and so many people facing devastating hardships. And there is intense resistance to our evolution and the digging in of powerful forces that protest change, that seek to maintain the status quo, and that seek to keep us stagnant and divided. Why? Because fear despises change. In fact, it devolves and wants to go backwards. But stay strong. Because the more that stagnant beliefs and corrupt systems are challenged, the more fear will dig its heels in, refusing to live in the land of compassion. Stay strong, for the tide will change. And you, yes, you beloveds, you are here to be part of that change. That is part of why your soul decided to come here at this very moment. It certainly didn't come for summers in Phoenix. Even though we could go out right now and enjoy a free sauna, it didn't come for that. It came, our souls came to be part of a movement. So, in the right hand, put all of your intentions and all of your blessings for humanity, and participate in holding a vision for the US and the world that calls forth not the basest, not the most despicable and the foulest of who we can be collectively, but instead the highest, the best, and the noblest of whom we can be together. And you might say, but the vision I want to hold for humanity is so different from what I see right now as I look out into the world, out into the US. I don't even know if I'll be on the planet for the time it may take to manifest. And then I say to you, beloveds, take courage and be inspired by one of my very favorite quotes. Now I know I have a bazillion favorite quotes, but this is one of those bazillion favorite quotes. The true meaning of life is to plant trees under whose shade you do not expect to sit. The true meaning of life is to plant trees under whose shade you do not expect to sit. Say that with me. And put it in the first person. The true meaning of life is to plant trees under whose shade I do not expect to sit. Yes, beloveds, that is indeed one of the true meanings of life. Now, this is a very crucial time in the US. And whatever your age, you, yes, you beloveds, you can participate in calling forth and seeing the vision of the world you want to create. Commit to seeing the most positive vision you can for the US and for humanity. And now take your left hand, which has all of your positive emotions, because you've released the ones that are negative, the ones that do not serve you, the ones that have no beneficial impact on you or on others. And now you merge it with the ideals and goals of your right by clasping your hands together, and use the full extent of your emotions to infuse your vision with unlimited power. You are energizing your intention for the US, your intention for the world, your intention for humanity with the synergy of your soul. And beloveds, even if you can only hold that vision for a minute a day, because all of the appearance of what is happening right now comes flooding into your mind, don't stress about it. Hold that vision of the US that you desire to live in, the world you desire to live in, and the planet that you desire to live on. Even if it's just for a moment, hold it. Hold it and meld it together. Beloveds, we must, and I really say must, so you know it's a really crucial thing. We must evolve into a global community of care. For those of us who currently call this planet home, for those of us who are just arriving on this planet, new babies are arriving every day, and for those who have yet to come. For as the Dalai Lama says, love and compassion are necessities, not luxuries. Without them, humanity cannot survive. Beloved, let us pray. Loving Mother, Father, God, we lift up all who are suffering as a result of what is happening across the world right now. Financial hardships, devastation, death, and destruction. We lift up all who are suffering that they might be uplifted by the presence of the divine. We also hold this vision. We hold this vision, even if it is for 1 minute a day. Allow us, Divine Spirit, to keep this vision of the world, the US that we desire to live in our mind, amid all that is going on. Give us the strength to remember every single day that we have the choice, and we can commit to holding this vision of the reality of the world that we choose to live in. And especially beginning with the US. And even if other things come upon us and distract us, bright, shiny things that distract us, let us turn to our vision and hold it clearly in our mind. Let us not beat up upon ourselves if we can only hold it for one pure minute a day. But let us congratulate ourselves for having that vision and intending to hold it. And maybe that 1 minute will grow to 2 minutes, and then it will grow to 5 minutes, and then it will grow to longer. And we find ourselves with throughout the day, allowing our mind to focus on the world that we are desiring to live in. We don't deny our feelings. Let us not deny any of the emotions that are coming up. These are really challenging times, God. You know that. And let us not deny those feelings, but let us release those feelings that ultimately will not be beneficial to us. And let us stand in strength, affirming and proclaiming the world that we desire to live in. Thank you, God, for the immediate manifestation of this prayer. We release, we let it go, and we know that it is so. Amen. Thank you so much, beloveds, for being a blessing to humanity. And thank you for being a blessing to Unity of Tempe. Divine love through me blesses and multiplies. For as we give, we receive. As we give, we receive. As we give, we receive. And we are so grateful for all of you who continue to support Unity of Tempe. It's very, very needed so that we can continue to bring these messages of hope and inspiration and courage and support during these challenging times. So we're going to close out a little differently today. Zephyrin has prepared for us a healing sound meditation. And should you choose to do so, I invite you to engage in the process that I shared today. Into your left hand, as you listen to the meditation, place all of your emotions, everything that you want to put in there. Let it go in there. And then the ones that are not beneficial to you, just or beneficial to humanity, let them just run through like sand, let them go. And then into your right hand, place your vision for the US, your vision for humanity, for the best, the highest, the noblest of us all. And then when that's bright, when you can see it very clearly, allow the two to come together with the positive emotions and your vision for the US and for humanity. Beloveds, I love you. Have a peaceful week, and I invite you to join us on Facebook Live at 10 a.m. on Sunday mornings, and also on our Zoom calls on Thursday at 10 a.m.
Namaste. And for my musical inspiration, I'd love to offer some sound to soothe us, to help us calm ourselves in the times that we're in right now. I felt that this was perhaps the best approach for our musical and sound healing. I'm going to take some deep breaths. And as you breathe, grounding.